My body clock does not allow me to come.
আমার সরাই দিয়ে রাইতে না ভাই।
I did put alarm and rang, then it stopped. That's why I apologize and I'm willing to the director's alarm for my language. But I came on time before the launch, before 1 o'clock. So this is great pleasure for me to be here to all people. And I want to register my thanks to IUN, in particular Director General, Ms. Andy Fong, to launch this report in Dhaka. First of all, before launching outside Geneva in last 73 years' time. Thank you. And I want to thank Andy Fong to take the trouble to travel to Bangladesh and to launch this report. Distinguished audience, the five major takeaways from the report from our perspective are, first, the actual number of international migrants remains below 400 million, constituting only 3.6% of the human population. Female migrants comprise 14% of the people on the move across borders. Most people, however, choose to leave within their national borders. These facts deserve to be highlighted again and again to dispel or disprove the negative xenophobia impression about migration propagated to southern western quarters. Second, the regular pathways for international migration are getting narrowed down for developing countries, while they keep broadening for developed countries. This does not correlate with the demand side of labor market in advanced economies with aging societies or skill shortages. I would urge IOM, along with its partners, to keep exploring possibilities for widening legal migration pathways in parallel with this current preoccupation with the return of migrants from certain destination or transit countries. Third, the importance of migration as a vehicle for sustainable development is reinforced by the fact that international remittance flow has grown by 650% in the last 24 years' time. Most notably, the volume of remittances has outstripped that of both official development assistance, ODA, and foreign direct investment, FDI, from developed to developing countries. It is therefore of utmost importance to facilitate remittance flow from official channels to maximize its development impacts. Fourth, the need for migration from a human security lens is getting more pronounced than ever before. The acute vulnerabilities experienced by migrants stranded at border, deported to and detained in offshore locations or left to perish without search and rescue efforts at seas and the present manifestation of policy responses that perpetuate systematic abuse and discrimination against migrants. It is rather ironic that most international human rights actors prefer to remain silent on the need for ratification of the International Convention on the Rights of Migrant Workers and their families by major destination countries. Fifth, the compound effect of humanitarian crisis, health emergencies, climate change, and digital transformation of human mobility are likely to reshape global migratory trends in fundamental ways. While most of the movement would perhaps occur internally, some forms of displacement are bound to have cross-border implications. Thanks to the work of IOM and others, the particular issue of climate mobility is finally getting some traction. I thank Director General. She has taken note of this fact because climate change is a reality today. And when IOM was established, then climate change was absent. But in Bangladesh, you know, because of the climate change, there are thousands, not thousands, millions of people are displaced internally, and also some people are displaced internationally in Bangladesh. That is the case in other countries. Distinguished audience, the WMR 2024 makes a compelling case about ever growing number of forced displacement due to conflicts and violences. You know, the Director General has mentioned how many people are displaced due to Russia-Ukraine war. 7 million people are displaced. Almost 40% of the total population of Ukraine are displaced in Europe and elsewhere because of this conflict. And you know what is happening in Gaza? Gaza has become a prison now, and these helpless people are persecuted. And what in that area, more than 10 million people have been displaced due to the conflict. And you know what is happening in Bangladesh? We are facing the challenges of forcibly displaced people from Myanmar. Now the number is about 1.3 million, not 1.2 million. Because every year, 35,000 newborn children. So every year it is increasing. And Bangladesh is a overpopulous country. The density of population in this country is the highest in the world. Per square kilometer, 1,260 people. This is the highest in the world. Still, we have given refuge. Our Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina was very generous to give refuge to these displaced people. But we are facing the challenges because of these people. Law and order situation, drug trafficking, human trafficking, and the Rohingya camps have become leading space for fanatism and terrorism. I thank Director General, who she has visited Kaksabazar, and with her own eyes, we have seen the situation there. Excellencies, it goes without saying that our nearly 12 million people are working in different countries, and they are playing a very important role in our economy. And they are providing remittances, and we are number eight remittance recipient country in the world. And sixth country from where number of population, in terms of the number of population, are working abroad in number six. We owe it to their individual toils, sacrifices, and success to make sure that global migration discourse are exemplified by knowledge products like WMR 2024. Place their issues, concerns, and priorities right at the center. I wish the World Migration Report 2024 the widest possible dissemination of success. And as IOM has chosen Bangladesh to launch the report, first ever launching of report outside Geneva, we shall work with you, and Bangladesh support time will continue.